Good morning. Okay, so this morning, this is my very first saltwater flush. So therefore, I am going to be letting you guys know what my results are and how I feel about it and if I'll do it again and vice versa. So therefore, here's my water. What I did last night, I boiled some. I heated some up, and then I had some regular. I did mine with distilled water. I've seen many, many different recipes. Some recipes I said seen 2 teaspoons. I don't know if they made a mistake. And then most websites I've seen 2 tablespoons of sea salt water with 32 ounces of water. I ended up doing 2 tablespoons of pure sea salt. So we'll see. People that they say who needs, prior to research, who needs a sea salt cleanse is people that are gassy, irritable bowel syndrome, some digestive problems. If you have 1 or less bowel movement each day, which is what I've been experiencing here lately, I added a little bit more protein, even though it's hemp, into my diet. And I've just noticed that my body might not, maybe my body just doesn't need that. I don't know. But I'm going to see what happens. They say something, if you have skin, as in psoriasis, skin issues, allergy issues, we all know our true health is in our digestive system. So I wanted to go get some colonics 2 days worth, but I didn't make my appointment. I totally forgot. So I'm just going to see how this works, and then I'm going to follow up with probably colonic next week or so, you know. So, but they do say that it's good for people that eat a lot of protein. I know I'm not eating a lot of protein or dairy products or anything like that, but I just did want to pass that on. This is definitely something that, I don't know, it's worth it. I've been knowing about it for years, but I just now decided to say, maybe I'll do it. So as far as the sea salt cleanse method, you flush out your system, you know, we're going to keep our colon healthy and clean. But the best part, it actually, it cleanses your GI tract. And it's supposed to get everything out from the mouth to the bottom to the end. Yeah. You get it? Mouth to the bottom to the end. Yikes. I've read people that had diarrhea or whatever. I don't know. I'm kind of nervous about this, guys. That's why I decided to do a rest day today, because I do not want to be going to the public bathroom having to take a dump. I don't even like using public bathrooms, so I can't even imagine having to take a dump and squat while taking a dump. Ugh, okay, I know. That's probably too much of a visual. But anyway, that's what I'm going to do. I am going to post. Some people do it in routines, but honestly, I mix mine with sea salt and Himalayan salt. I decided to just see how it works. Hey, it's my body. If it's any repercussions, I'm willing to deal with that from trying this out. So I'm not telling you to go out and do it. I'm just telling you, hey, do some research. If you've done it before, please list what happened, your experiences down below. I'm very open to hearing that. The recipe that I'll be sharing, it does say when you first wake up, you know, you drink, before you eat or drink anything, including coffee, you do this. They say add 1 tablespoon of high quality sea salt, Himalayan salt, if you have it, to 1 quart of room temperature water. Now, of course, I told you I did 2 tablespoons. I've seen a lot of, I just decided to do 2 tablespoons. I'm a bit of extremist, so don't try to do what I did, what I'm doing. I mean, I'll let you know how it goes, okay? It says in slightly warm water, it can increase your maximum results, and it also may help speed up the process. The taste of the flush, they say it's going to be very, very salty. I'm just preferred to, I'm trying to drink it, slam it down, okay? Now, after you drink it, They say you should lay on your side, preferably your right side. It's always contradictions in anything you read, guys. One thing will say one thing will say, I'm gonna lay on my right side. And they say you should start having bowel movements in 1 to 2 hours. And they say the first bowel movement can happen within the first half hour. So don't be getting in your car or headed to work right away, okay? So they're just saying that if you're waiting, when you're waiting for your first bowel movement, you lay on your side and you massage your abdominal area for about 10 minutes and then flip to the other side and repeat. That's what some sites say. Some sites just say lay on one side, okay? Hey, it might not work. I don't know. Do some research. All I got to say is this is what I'm doing, and I'm just sharing with you guys. I'm sharing with you guys what I'm doing. OMG. Okay? I'll be back. Okay, guys, look, I got this much left. I ain't finishing it. I'm tapping out because I don't know. Maybe, the mind is so powerful. My eyes starting to hurt. I'm like, was this the saw? I'm just being real. I don't think I want to do this anymore. I mean, my goal was, I mean, I didn't try straws. I didn't try this. I got stream water, drinking this down. I mean, guys, this ain't, everything isn't for everybody. And I just don't know, honestly. I'm just gonna keep it real. I don't know if I'm gonna finish right now. I think I'm about to go lay down. Just can't tell you nothing else about it. Like, I give y'all props. I mean, I knew it should have been a reason why I ain't never did this mess because I mean, I didn't try everything, okay? I didn't did everything. Anything you can probably think of, but I ain't never did this. And it was probably something in me that knew, okay, Tamara, leave it alone. That ain't for you, you know? But no, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that tomorrow. I'm going to tell you, I feel like I got to tell you something right now. And I ain't even drunk all this. So I don't know if I really want to put myself through that, if you know what I mean. I don't know. Deep breath, positive thoughts. I'll let you know. I just wanted you guys to see this. My body rejected it. I threw up. Like, I just finished throwing up for like over a minute. Okay. Ooh, my eyes are watering. I'm not crying. I still think okay, this is no cussing challenge. This is really messing me up. But I really, like I said before, this is not for me, and that is the reason why I probably never did it. And this is just to show you that everything ain't for everybody, okay? I haven't heard many people say they threw up. I did. So, like I said earlier, this just confirms the fact that it's not for me. And that goes with anybody else. Just think if I would have finished drinking all of that, instead of listening to my body, like, no, you don't drink it. I didn't drink any more of it since the last time I showed you that picture. It just came over me and I felt like I was gonna vomit everywhere, so I don't know if I'm still going to have a bowel movement, but my body totally, when I tell you, it was disgusting. But anyways, I just had to come back and let you know. I'm still going to be doing the video to for another 2 hours to tell you the symptoms, but so far it is 6:33. Oh, 33, my number. This is not, I'm not doing this anymore. Hey guys, so okay, this is the same day. I went to bed and laid down on my side, like they said, massaged my stomach. I mean, the last time you see me, I had just finished throwing up. I threw up multiple times, but that was my last time. All of it came up. Since I did it on the empty stomach, nothing came up with it. I did see like one chunk of green bean I ate yesterday, which is kind of crazy because it didn't digest already because I had already ate it. But whatever. It was this green bean. I seen it. So the moral to this for me, learning experiences, others have cured things, others have passed kidney stones, others have did all these great things on this cleanse. It cleansed their digestive tract and everything. But like I told you before, a long time ago, my spirit was like, that ain't for you. But then I had this, oh, I'm gonna do it, you know? Well, you know what? The body talks. So imagine if I would have just kept drinking and not stopping. And when I said I should listen to my body. So I listened to my body. I stopped. The moment I stopped, I said, okay, I'm listening. That's what I said. I talked to it. I'm not going to drink anymore. You direct and tell me what you need, and I will listen. And that's what happened. And I just started throwing up. Because before, I didn't feel like I was going to throw up. I felt like I was about to have a bowel movement. Like it was pushing pressure on the backside of my butt. So, I mean, I tried it. Hey, it's one more experience, but can I say, oh, the salt flush doesn't work, blah, 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 all this crazy stuff like some people do after they take one product? No, I will not say that. I will say that it did not work for me. It was not for my body. I listened to my body, and your body will let you know what you need. It'll let you know the nutrients you're deficient in, the foods. You just have to get in tune. And one way for you to get in tune is to start meditating, start silencing your mind and listening. And listening, I know I probably sound crazy to some of you guys, but I'm dead serious. Okay, meditate and start listening. Listening to what's going on inside, because that's the only way I found out when something's not right. And that goes for intuition-wise, when dealing with people, and I'll be like, they vibe is off. I can't, this they ain't for me. It's not for me. Emotionally, it goes back to my post I posted yesterday. Emotionally, I'm all in it. But wisdom has to come before. You base your actions off of wisdom, not emotions, okay? And when I did this, honestly, I was basing it off of emotion, or maybe I shouldn't say emotion, but I was curious to see what it do for me. But I kind of already knew that I wanted to really go to the bathroom. I wanted to say, yeah, I'm going to take a big dump, you know? But my body was like, nope, not going to happen, honey. Nope, that's not what you need to be doing. So, whatever. That is my experience, my capital MY experience with the salt flesh cleanse. Thank you. Okay, guys, so this didn't work for me, but it may work for you. Just do your research and always listen to your body. I've heard many success stories doing this flush with people that had low energy levels, gallstones, and many more things. If you're interested, look in the description box and I will list some links for you guys, but everything doesn't work for everybody. And this is kind of like my post I posted on Instagram yesterday. One person's food is another man's poison. It is definitely true. You have to listen to your body. Thank you.